three fronts. The first of that is emissions management and better still, emissions reduction. We understand that there are groups of countries experiencing different levels of development, and therefore necessarily will have different levels of emissions. But the process is clear. We have spoken before, most recently in the Bali Action Group, that the major emitters in the industrial countries must take the major responsibility for the past and the major responsibility as we move forward. So emission reduction is important. We'll do an update on our part. So we have come here for those emissions to be legally committed. Secondly, we want these emissions in the past and in the future, adaptation and mitigation, to be contained in a legally binding instrument also. And we want the financing for that to be predictable, to be adequate, and to be accessible. For that, we need a legal instrument. And thirdly, we need a legal instrument because we need all these governance and management mechanisms to be collectively agreed to and to be consistent across the board. Again, for that, we need a legally binding. That is why AOSIS, consistent with the mandate of our head, we met in New York in September of this year, instructed us to come here and engage to prepare for them so that they can prepare for all climates. And we have therefore this morning released our version, which contains our vision of what a legally binding instrument from COP15 could contain, substance and form that protects the safety, security, and integrity of the small island states, low-lying coastal areas. That is our membership in the first instance, and everybody else as well. I pass the floor to my colleague from the Minister of Environment and Climate.
Thank you very much, Ambassador. As the Ambassador has said, care is really important for our survival. Survival is the